We need an evergreen topic. You know what's always safe? Batman.
I love Batman.
Earl Batman, always good. Sidekicks, usually always good.
Usually.
Usually. So, who is his best Robin ever?
Best Robin ever.
Best Robin ever. I have to go with Dick Grayson. The first and best Robin.
Robin classic.
Robin, yeah. Classic Robin.
I'm going to go with...
A little newer Robin than Jason Todd?
Yes, I'm going to go with Tim Drake.
Okay, not newest, but newer.
No, I'm leaving Damian Wayne in the gutter where he should have been left.
I hear he was good. But he is no Dick Grayson, because Dick Grayson established Robin as the character. He established everything we need to know about Robin, and he established pretty much everything we need to know about a sidekick. He is the very, really the first sidekick. I'm not going to claim he's the first ever, but he's the first that everyone remembers to this day and still likes. That is hard to do, Kyle.
He is the definition of a sidekick, is Robin.
The plucky kid sidekick, which was perfect juxtaposition to Batman. Very serious, gritty. My parents were killed. But no, you have Dick Grayson. Golly gee willikers, Batman. Holy cow. Holy macaroni, Batman. It's like everything just super happy. Like, he's basically Andy Griffith character plunked into Batman, and he's just so happy to be there and to help out.
And there's something to be said about the history involved with Dick Grayson, but the one thing that was weird is that he stayed as Robin just a little too long, and it got to the point where the Boy Wonder was now a dude, like a full-grown dude running around in short pants.
Well, they addressed
that. Kind
of
weird. Tim Drake was great because we actually got a Robin who was a boy again, and with that came all of the things... All the weaknesses that come with being a boy and not understanding the world you've just stumbled into. He was overconfident. He stumbled through a lot of his training. He didn't understand where his loyalties lied sometimes with Batman. On top of that, he was also a Robin for the new generation of comic book readers.
Sure.
He was a computer kid. He was a computer genius. He used his powers of deduction to divine who Batman was, who, as we've stated previously, how come nobody else in Gotham could do that?
Sure, he's impressive. I don't want him as my Robin. If I need a Robin to go into the battlefield, I go with the one that actually broke off and became his own superhero for a while. Nightwing is not a bad superhero, I'll tell you what.
I'll tell you what.
He had his own thing, and he's like, you know what, Batman, you taught me so much. And again, yeah, I'm too old to be the Boy Wonder. I'm a man now. I have needs, and you're
not... Did you read that part where he became Nightwing? Because it was not a very respectful, you've taught me everything, now I'm gonna go off and... No, it was F you! Take back the stupid short pants, I'm gonna start wearing a grown-up's outfit.
Because eventually he grew up, and yeah, this was... We got to see everything from start to finish with the original Robin. Dick Grayson is what you want. And again, he became Nightwing, which was a good competent superhero on his own. He's like, you know, I'm not even gonna bother with Gotham anymore, you got that, I'm gonna go to Bloodhaven, because... It sounds darker than Gotham.
I thought it was Bloodhaven with the umlaut.
I like to say Bloodhaven because that's just more fun.
The one thing I gotta say about Tim Drake is that he rivaled actual Batman as far as his deductive reasoning, to the point where Ra's al Ghul actually referred to him as detective.
Hmm.
Which, that's... If you're a Batman reader, you know, that's a big moment. And it validated Tim Drake as being... worthy of being part of the Batman family, which a lot of people didn't like him when he first showed up.
The Joker. We gotta pull the Joker into this.
If we have to.
Obviously, who did the Joker kind of pull the biggest Joker on? Well, that was Jason Todd.
Yeah.
He Todded him out. However, you could kind of tell he was bored with that. It was like, this is too easy. I can just kill you because you're a stupid whiny little bitch. However, at one plot arc... He pulls this elaborate stunt to break Dick Grayson, to ruin Dick Grayson. A whole wonderful thing where he pushes him past his limit, not to kill him, but to make Dick Grayson attempt to kill the Joker, which he does. He beats him until his heart stops beating, and then Batman resuscitates him because Batman, and he comes back, and then he walks away, but he knows Dick took a life in that moment. Like, he was trying to take a life, and Dick knew. And that's how much the Joker
even says, look, the best Robin is the one I'm going to focus my anguish on. Sure, Jason Todd, boom! But that was really the fans that decided he was gone. This is the Joker saying, I've picked my sidekick rival. This one, number one. Number one sidekick is you, Boy Wonder, Night Wonder, whatever. I'm going to break you. And he did. Let's just take this to more current. Dick Grayson became Batman. And his run as Batman was great. He was a new fun Batman. He was just, like you say, oh no, Bruce Wayne is dead, oh no. But then you find Dick Grayson, like, I don't know. Oh, I love this. He's great as Batman. Keep him as Batman. Oh, Bruce Wayne is back? Crap. I don't care. Dick Grayson should stay best Robin ever.
So he can't be best Batman and best Robin.
Yes, he can.
When Bruce Wayne died, everybody in the universe of Batman just decided, okay, well, that's it for original Batman. So Dick Grayson jumps into the cowl. Everything's cool. We're going to have a new Batman. Tim Drake says, uh-uh. Au contraire. I'm going to scour the globe looking for him because I don't buy it. Just like actual comic book readers didn't buy it. There's no way in hell that they killed off Bruce Wayne permanently. And sure enough, Tim Drake knew enough to know that, and he scoured the globe looking for him so that we could have our Batman back. What better Robin could you think of who would do that?
Dick Grayson.
So we decided that Tim Drake is the superior Robin.
Because,
Essentially because Dick Grayson, while he was the original Robin and the quintessential sidekick, he did grow out of it eventually.
And he was like the understudy that hoped that the lead kind of, you know, got shot by a god bullet.
Yeah, well, maybe not that specific, but essentially Tim Drake was all about, I want to help Batman, whereas Dick Grayson, a part of him, wanted to become Batman.
At the very least, neither of these are Stephanie Brown.
Or Jason Todd. F you, Red Hood.